a safe distance from each other. Please sing and pray with us as you would in church. The program is available for download. Now let us sing together, Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are the way, truth, and the life. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May your people let us know forever, O God, and renew the fruitfulness of the Spirit, so that rejoicing now, when there is more glory of our adoption, we may look forward to what we have hope. To the rejoicing of the day of resurrection, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you standing in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man condemned to you by God, with mighty deeds and wonders and signs, which God worked through him in your midst. You yourselves know. This man delivered up by a set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your holy one to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.' My brothers, what can I confidently say to you about the patriarch David, that he died and was buried? And his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him, that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses, exalted at the right hand of God. He received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured it forth as you see and hear. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. him who judges impartially, according to each one's works. Conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your feeble conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with imperishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless and blemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
How slow of heart to believe all that the prophet spoke.
Was it not necessary that Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them and referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave an impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. Then it happened that while he was with them at table, he took the bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. The CEO of Southeastern Grocers, which owns Winn Dixie, wrote in a statement the following: "Southeastern Grocers is dedicated to being there for the community when they need us the most, and we believe there is no better time than now to show acts of kindness." And Tyler Perry spoke about the importance of staying positive during this time, and how even small acts of kindness can spread hope and unite communities. So, if you're looking for a silver lining in all this craziness, this just might be it. Grocery people literally putting their very lives on the line to help first responders, hospital workers, police, firefighters, who are also putting their lives on the line every day. All future saints in the making. Think about that. Future saints in the making by risking their own lives for others. And I guarantee that anyone who saw these acts of kindness on the nightly news were as deeply moved as I was. It says something about human nature,
We rise to the occasion. But it also describes something powerful. Something that is at the heart of our lives as Christians. In fact, it's at the heart of today's gospel. And all the gospels we've been hearing in these weeks after Easter. The reading serves as a reminder that so much of our faith isn't individual. It is looking out for one another, helping one another, praying for one another, and praying with one another. It is communal. Look at the scriptures from Easter Sunday onward. Jesus didn't appear to his followers one by one. The encounters all happened in groups. The two women at the tomb, the many disciples gathered in the upper room, and now two disciples traveling on the road to Emmaus. That meeting leads not only to communion, the breaking of the bread, but to a deepening desire, a need to spread the news to the community of believers. The disciples who met Jesus couldn't continue on their way. They couldn't just pick up where they left off on the path they had followed. They had to go back and tell others. And so much of the resurrection story is about telling that story, spreading the word. And we see it here once again at this Mass. It's a story that cannot be contained. The good news has to be shared. Our life as Catholic Christians is not only about communion, it's also about community. Too often people forget that. Now, I can imagine how frustrating we all are that we cannot come together these days as a community to celebrate the Mass. But feel blessed that through this meeting, you can spiritually receive Jesus in the Eucharist. You can receive him in your hearts. And how great is that? This weekly celebration is something fundamental to the faith. It's a sense of being part of something greater than yourself, of being part of the body of Christ, even from a distance. It's a shared experience of God's grace, that same experience that compelled the two men on the road to Emmaus to run back to Jerusalem and tell others what they encountered. This isn't something that's meant to be kept to ourselves. It's meant to be lived, practiced, and prayed with others. What we have here is an extraordinary gift, and it's not something we should take for granted. The Church understands that, but part of the reason for that is because of what happens here. On this table, we encounter Jesus in the breaking of the bread, just like the men on the way to Emmaus. To reject that, to walk away from it, is to reject the one who is at the center of our celebration. It is to reject Jesus. Obviously, I'm preaching to the choir. You who are watching now know that. But please invite your friends, especially the fallen away Catholics. Those are the people who need to hear this message. So, after you finish watching this Mass today, be like the disciples who met Jesus on that road. Something transcendent and transformative is happening here today. And when it is over, we need to go tell others. We need to tell them not only with words, but with our lives. We need to bring that Jesus into the world. We don't know if those disciples ever reached Emmaus, but we do know this much. Their travels were interrupted, and the direction of their journey was changed because of an encounter with the risen Lord. In some way, that is every Christian's story. But it's not one that we should keep to ourselves. Our faith is about community, and it's about community. Just like those grocery workers and grocery responders in Louisiana. It is meant to be shared. Please try and do so in every way possible. God is counting on you, and you
on him.
Let us now pray for faith, every evening, O God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things that is lost and to us, everything in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born from the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, most substantial of the Father. To him all things were made, for us is heaven, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. Spirit was the present of the Virgin Trinity and became man. For our sake, crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to glory to judge the living and the dead, and is seated above the isle of man. And we in the Holy Spirit, the Lord of eternal life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son of the Lord and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets, I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now raise our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the gift of awareness on the journey of faith, that we may always recognize Christ walking with us, we pray to the Lord. For a deepening of our love and hunger for the Word of God in the Eucharist, we pray to the Lord. For all who are ill, particularly those with COVID-19, that the risen Lord will bring an end to the virus and give hope, healing, and new life to those who are sick, we pray to the Lord. For all who work in essential jobs to try to protect them and their families from illness and give them strength to fulfill their responsibilities, we pray to the Lord. For Phil Carlo, Ernesto and Adela Spadaccini, Molly Behan, Jacinta Pierce McCarthy, Dominic Bufovio, and St. Aloysius parishioners, whom our masses offer this weekend, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased brothers and sisters, that God may raise them up to the new life of His risen Son, we remember those who have died recently: Cecilia Carroll, Anthony Ciccone, James Henson, Tony Giaffi, Cerrero Mendoza, Teresa Swaybo, Patsy Cataro, and Monsignor Roger Watts. We pray to the Lord. Let us now pray for all those intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we receive these prayers. We ask that you be sent of our Holy Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst men. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. Blessed in our way, when someone was ended, he took the chalice, and giving thanks, he said, blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially in the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Aloysius and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm into faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant. Your servant Francis, our Pope and Friar of our mission, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
With the gracious and prayers of this young lady, whom you have summoned before you, in your compassion on the merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you and
My Jesus.
I believe you are
really
here.
In the Blessed Sacrament.
I love you more than
anything
in the world.
And I hunger to receive you. But since I cannot receive communion at this moment,
feed my soul at least spiritually.
I unite myself to you now,
as I do when I actually receive you.
Oh.
Look with kindness upon our people, O Lord, and grant us pray that those who are pleased to read by eternal histories may attain a dark